This is the last assignment for the looping problems. So what this particular problem is asking us to do is, it's trying to tell, given a natural number greater than 1 or given any natural number, tell us whether that number is a prime number or not. So let's first clearly define and understand what is a prime number so that we are able to solve this particular problem. Now, the first step is, a prime number is a natural number which is greater than 1 and has exactly 2 distinct natural number divisors. What are those natural number divisors? The natural number divisors are the number 1 and itself. So what I am going to do here is, first I need to read a number from the user. Once the user enters a number, I am going to start trying to divide it by 2. So if the number is divisible by 2, then that particular number can never be a prime number because it's an even number. Then what happens here is, I also need to take care of numbers like 2, 3 so that they print as prime numbers. Then how long should you continue to divide a number? Suppose the input number is say 37. There is no point of trying to divide 37 till 35 or 36 because the last number which can divide 37 by the mathematical proof is the square root of 37. So square root of 37 will come somewhere around 6 point something. So any number beyond 7 is, if it's not dividing, there's no point of checking for any number beyond 7 to see whether it can divide 37. So using this understanding, let us first develop the logic, and the things will be completely clear once we do a test run or a test case run. So I am reading a number. Then once I read a number, my condition is going to be, how long should I keep trying to divide that particular number? I am going to divide that particular number as long as the value of the divisor is less than or equal to square root of that number. So in case of 37, the last value of divisor is going to be 7. After 7, there is no point in trying to divide 37 by the divisor. Now the first step is, I am trying to start with 2. So if number is say, let's say number is 6. So 6 mod 2 is 0. So that means it's an even number. Then I am going to say, number 6 is not a prime number, and I am going to go to the end or going to stop. Now then there are other possibilities. Let's try to take a look at it. Suppose the number is say 13. Then what is going to happen here is, I am going to come up with this. Now the divisor initially is 2. You will understand why I am doing this step once we do the dry run. So please bear with me. If divisor is greater than 2, I am increasing divisor by 2 because after I check the division by even numbers, I should only be worried about trying to divide that input number only by odd numbers. So once the divisor becomes 3, I want to see that the divisor goes to 5, 7, 9, 11 and so on. No point in trying to check with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, because a number which is divisible by 6, 8 and 10 is definitely going to be divisible by 2. So I am not going to check with even numbers after 2. So after the divisor becomes 3, I am going to increase divisor by 2. Now this particular process is going to continue. So let me push this a little up because this is the main part and there's really nothing major other than this part. So what I am going to do here is, I am going to put this particular part here. Then once I put this particular part, I will come to step number 4. If the divisor has become greater than the square root of the number, and if the input number is greater than 1, I am straight away going to say number is a prime number. So in order to understand this logic, let's take a look at a run. Okay. So in this run, what I am going to do here is, I am going to take some data values. So let's say the input number, I am reading the number as 2. So number is 2, divisor is also 2. Now, what about 2? 2 is the divisor. Square root of 2 is 1.41. So this condition initially only will fail because 2 is not less than or equal to 1.41. So I will directly come to step number 4. Now what about the number? Number 2 is greater than 1. So I am going to say 2 is a prime number. Okay, it's dealt with 2 perfectly. Let's take a case of number being 3. Number is 3, square root of 3 is 1.73, divisor is 2. 2 is less than or equal to 1.73 is again false. 3 is greater than 1, 3 is a prime number. So I have dealt with 2 and 3. Let's take the next number, which is 4. Since I am reading the number as 4, divisor is 2. 2 is less than or equal to square root of 4 happens to be 2. So this is okay. So I will come into the loop. 4 mod 2 is equal to 0. So it will say 4 is not a prime number and it will come to stop. Okay, so it has dealt with 2, 3 and 4 perfectly. Let's take now a number which is slightly higher, 23. So square root of 23 happens to be somewhere 4.79, or you can consider it equal to 5. Divisor is 2. 23 mod 2, is it equal to 0? No. So I will come here. Divisor is 2. Is 2 greater than 2? No. So I will increase divisor by 1. So divisor now ends up becoming 3. I am increasing divisor for the first time when it is not greater than 2 by 1, because I want 2 to become 3. And from next time, I want to see this 3 to become 5, 7 and so on. So after it becomes greater than 2, I am going to increase the divisor by 2 to numbers. So this becomes 3. 3 is less than or equal to 4.79. Now number is 23. 23 mod 3, is it equal to 0? No. So I will come here. Now what is divisor? Divisor is 3. 3 is greater than 2 is true. So divisor from 3 will end up becoming 5. Okay, it will end up becoming 5. So once it becomes 5, I go back here. Is 5 less than or equal to 4.79? This condition is false. I will come here. Number is 23 greater than 1? Yes. So 23 is a prime number. I'll give you one more example so that it becomes entirely clear. Okay. I have a number 33. Divisor is 2. 2 is less than or equal to square root of 33 is 5.74. Now 33 divided by 2, the remainder is not 0. The remainder is 1. So I will come here. Divisor is still 2. So since divisor is 2, 2 is not greater than 2. So divisor will become equal to 2 plus 1 becomes 3. Is 3 less than or equal to 5.74? Absolutely. Now 33 divided by 3, the remainder is going to be 0. So it will say 33 is not a prime number. Go to stop. It will come here. The best way to understand this particular flowchart, okay, assuming you are starting from step number 1. So this is the first step, number 1 and 2. This is 3 and this is 4. I will suggest take at least 5 different numbers and run through this logic to understand whether it is working correctly or not. This is the only way to understand how logic works and be able to write your own code. So this is slightly a level higher for you, but with enough practice and over a period of time, the next 1 or 2 months, problems like this you'll be very able to easily solve and find the answer. So before testing, do not assume your logic is correct. Please make the test table and run through the logic to see that you are getting the correct output. Because for example, if you miss this particular step, you're going to get a completely wrong output. Alright, so with this, I try to end up the looping assignment solutions.